Welcome back to Dicky's Garage. On this video, I've got a huge announcement about the channel. Also, I'm going to give you an update on the Big Block Miata, and I got a box full of new parts to show you, so stay tuned. So I'm going to show you guys what's in the box in just a minute. Also, we're going to go over the Big Block Miata's current progress and what we're doing with it. But first, I told you I had a big announcement, and I do. Dicky's Garage hit its first 100 subscribers last night. That is awesome. Thanks to each and every one of you guys. You make this possible. I quite literally could not do this without you, because my wife would never let me spend this much time in the garage without your support. Otherwise, I'd probably be inside stuck watching Hawaii 5-0 or whatever you people watching these days. That's not me. I'm a garage monkey. This is where I live. So, with that said, let's see what's in this box and see what's going on with the Miata.
Why are you standing so close to me? What is going on here? Why are you following me?
Are you mad, bro? You look mad. So on the last update, I showed you guys we had the Miata suspension assembled. We had it on the ground. We had an issue with the quarter panel actually sitting directly on the tire, which is no good. We're going to fix that and put some spring perches in there and raise it up a bit. But before I go to setting anything as far as vehicle height or anything permanent, I had one big problem I had to solve. And in this box is the solution. So let's get this thing open and see what's cooking. Oh boy, we got a box within a box here. You know it's good quality stuff if that's the case. Let's get that box out of our way. See what's in this one. So what we have here is a set of tubular control arms. Check that out, right? They are racing red already. Didn't have to paint them. Got the spring perches there. They got the mount for the sway bars. Most importantly, though, it's got some bushings. So this is my problem. That's why the Miata still has a quarter panel sitting on a tire. Because I realized that without new bushings, and if I started welding things in and making it permanent as far as ride height, as soon as I changed the control arms out, that was all going to change. So for more accuracy, we went ahead and ordered these. So we've been waiting on these all week. They're here now, so I'm going to get them installed and see kind of what it looks like now. So out with the old, in with the new. If anything, these things look cool. But I did find one drawback to them already. And if you guys have ever ran cheap polyurethane bushings in a car, you'll know what I'm talking about. But listen, I ain't even tightened the bolts down yet, and it's already squeaking that much. So hopefully it won't be that bad. But if it is, I don't really care. This thing's not a driver. We're going to run it up and down the road for some shows, maybe. So now we can start moving forward with mounting some spring perches and getting the ride height set on this thing. And once we get that done, we're going to rip this all back apart and do some final reinforcing, and then be done with the rear axle. We can start moving forward on the car, get that front suspension done as well. So thanks to a little help from SVT Kevin, we managed to get the Miata outside and just get a good look at it to see what we think about the side profile of this really wide rear stance we've got. If you notice, it's a little close on the quarter panel. Now, I'm more concerned with pinion angles than I am clearance on a quarter panel, because I can always cut those back. But it's definitely tight, but it rolls. So I do like the extra height we gained in the rear, because I'm still going to lose some of that when I put the fuel cell and the radiator back in the trunk. But for now, I think we're in pretty good shape. I tell you, with a stance like this, I'm going to have to get a wide load sticker. But on that note, guys, I'm going to end this video off right there. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.